Hey guys, this is Jay. Today we are going to see how to design wedding album in Photoshop. Already I posted a wedding album tutorial and you guys found those videos quite helpful and requested for a new video. Finally, here it is. Before getting started, please do download the project file, link in the description. With the project file, it will be much easier for you to follow this tutorial. So download the project file and get ready. In case if you want the completely designed .psd album file means, hit the like button. Soon after reaching 500 likes, I'll give you the download link. Fine, let's get started. First, go to File, New and create a new canvas in Photoshop. Based on your requirements, create a canvas. Make sure the resolution is 300. If you're going to print the template means, make sure it is CMYK format, print format. Else, you can go to Project File. There you'll see a PSD file called Album Page 1. Open the file inside Photoshop. This one is design ready file. I have given you the color palette, the colors we are going to use in this design. Size is A4. Just for tutorial purpose, I created this file. You can use this. Page 1 going to be quite simple and easy. We're going to use pre-designed stock image, then our model image, followed by text content. First, let's start by dropping in our pre-designed stock image. Go to project file, open image 1 inside Photoshop. Drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Now enable free transform tool Ctrl T and resize it. Fine, next we are going to drop in our model image. Now go to project file. Open image 2 inside Photoshop. Of course you can use your image. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Make sure to place the model image right below our stock image. Fine, now enable free transform tool Ctrl T and resize it. Next we are going to add our text content, but our bottom part looks a little bit bright, so we are going to take care of that. We are going to create a minimal color effect. For that, let's start by creating a layer right above our model image. Now go to color picker and pick any color you want. I'm going with white color. Now fill the color using keyboard shortcut Alt Backspace. Now fill down to 0%. Now right click the layer, go to blending option, there select gradient overlay. Now click the gradient bar, there select the neutral density. By default you will have this option in your gradient bar. Make sure the bottom two color points are black color. Fine, now click OK. I'm not going to touch other settings, I'm going with same opacity 100. Mode normal, angle 90, scale 100. Now click OK. Now we want only the bottom part to be dark, not the entire canvas. We're going to take care of that. Now we're going to use eraser tool. Now pick the eraser tool. In the brush settings, I'm going with soft round brush, this one. Now increase the size and erase the top part of the layer completely. We will end with only the bottom part so that we will have that color effect only to the bottom part of the layer. Now this is before and after, we got that minimal dark effect. Now it's time to add our text content. Let's move to text group. Now create a layer. Now go to color picker, select any color you want. I'm going with this yellow color. Now type in your text. The font I'm using here is a free font. I'll give a link in the description. You can download it if you want. I'll create a duplicate copy, Ctrl J. Edit the text. I'll reduce the size a little bit. Once you're done, next it's time to add effects to our text content. Now right click the layer, first layer. Now go to blending option. There I'm going to first add drop shadows. There I'm going to keep the mode as normal, opacity as 100, angle as 90, distance as 13, spread as 10 and size as 18. Of course you don't need to go with exactly very same number, feel free to experiment with numbers and settings. This is before and after. Next, let's add glow effect. Now enable outer glow. There I'm going to keep the mode as normal. Opacity as 24. Noise as 0. I'm going to change the color to white. I'm not going to touch other settings. I'm going to keep the spread as 0 and size as 18. Now we got that minimal glow effect. Fine, once you're done, click OK. Now copy the layer style, right click and copy the layer style. Now paste the layer style to another layer. Fine, next we're going to add glow effects to make it look a little more attractive. For that, create a layer. I'll change the layer blending mode to color dodge. Now go to color picker, sample and select this kind of faded yellow color. Now click OK. Now pick the brush tool. There I'm going to pick soft round brush, this one. Now increase the size a little bit. Next, select the text layer. Now hold Ctrl key in your keyboard and click the thumbnail. By doing so, the entire text will be selected. Now roll back and select the glow effect layer. Now with brush, give single click on center part of the text. I'll give another click here. There you go, we got an attractive glow effect. This one is before and after. We're going to repeat the very same step for the another text layer. Select the another text layer, hold Ctrl key in your keyboard and click the thumbnail. Make a selection. Now roll back and select the glow effect layer. Now give a single click at the center here. There you go. Now hit Ctrl D to deselect. Now our page one is almost ready. All you got to do is now disable the color palette. Save the file. Now let's move to page two. Go to the project file. Open album page 2 inside Photoshop. As I said before, this one is a decent edit file either. Now let's start by creating a solid color background. Go to background group, create a layer, go to color picker, sample and select this yellow color. Now fill the color. I use the keyboard shortcut Alt Backspace. In this page, we're going to have a single image at the center here. We're going to use a custom shape as an image placeholder. Fine. Let's start by dropping in our custom placeholder image. Go to project file, open image 3 inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop this image inside our canvas. Make sure to place this image inside image group. I'll place it at the center here. Yes, I'm going to use this image as our image placeholder where we're going to drop in our image. In case if you want to create another custom size image placeholder, means go to shapes tool, select custom shapes. Now go to shapes panel and select any shapes you want and create your own image placeholder. Here I'm going to use this image as our image placeholder. Next we're going to drop in our image. Now go to project file, open image 4 inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Make sure to place the image right above our image placeholder. Now right click and clip mask the image. Now enable free transform to Ctrl T and resize it. Fine. Now our image looks completely flat and boring. We are going to add effects to make it look a little more interesting. For that, select the image placeholder layer. Now right click, go to blending option. There I'm going to select inside shadow. There I'll keep the mode as normal, opacity as 50, angle as 90, distance as 10, choke as 10, size as 20. Of course, feel free to experiment with numbers. Now we got that typical paper cut effect simply by adding the inside shadow effect. This one is before, looks completely flat, and this one is after, looks stunning. Now click OK. Next we're going to drop in few stock images. Before that, I'll move the color palette down below here. Fine. Next, go to the project file and drop in our stock images. Let's start by adding lamp image. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. I'll place it on right side here. Next, I'm going to create a duplicate copy of this layer by using keyboard shortcut Ctrl J. I'll move it a little bit up. Next, I'll create another copy, Ctrl J. I'll move it to left side here. Another copy, Ctrl J. I'll place it on top here. Fine. Next, we're going to add our moon image. For that, go to the project file. Open the moon stock image inside Photoshop. This one is a PNG file. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. I'm going to place it on left side bottom here. Now enable free transform tool Ctrl T and reduce the size if you want. Fine. Next, I'm going to add text content on right side bottom. Go to text group, create a layer. Go to color picker, pick any color you want. I'm going with orange color. I'm using very same font we used on page 1. Now time to add glow effect, create a layer, change the layer blending mode to color dodge. Now go to color picker, sample and select this kind of faded yellow color. Now pick the brush tool. I'm going to pick the soft round brush. We're going to repeat the very same step we did on page 1. Hold Ctrl key and click the text layer thumbnail. Now roll back and select the glow effect layer. Now give a single click. Hit Ctrl D to deselect. There you go. We got our glow effect. Next, I'll reduce the flow down to something around 60 to 50%. This one is optional. Now give few clicks on stock images to create attractive glow effects. I'll give one here, another one here. Fine, once you're done, our page 2 is ready. Now close the groups, disable the color palette, save the file. Now let's move to page 3. Go to project file, open album page 3 inside Photoshop. And yes, this one to design ready file. Let's start by creating solid color background, create a layer, go to color picker, sample and select this yellow color. Fill the color using keyboard shortcut Alt Backspace. In this page, we are going to add 4 images, one on left side and 3 images on right side. Let's start by creating image placeholder on left side. Go to image, create a layer. Now go to color picker, select black color. Now pick rectangle tool. Make sure fill is enabled, stroke is disabled. Now create a rectangle shape like so. And yes, this one going to be our image placeholder where we are going to drop in our image. Now trying to drop in our model image. Now go to project file, open image 5 inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Make sure to place the image right above our image placeholder. Now right click and clip mask the image. Now resize the image by enabling free transform tool Ctrl T. Fine, once you're done, next we're going to add border designs for this image. Now go to project file, open the borderdesign.png file inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. This one is a pre-designed image. I'm going to place this image right below our image placeholder. I'll move it to left side. Adjust the position using your keyboard arrow keys. Once you're done, next I'm going to change the color. If you want, you can settle with black color. It's optional. I'm going to change it to some kind of bright color. For that, right click the layer. Go to blending option, there select color overlay. There I'm going to change the color to some kind of bright yellow color. This one. Click OK. As I said before, this one is optional. If you want, you can settle with black color. Next, I'm going to create a duplicate copy of this layer by using keyboard shortcut Ctrl J. I'll move it to right side. Now enable free transform tool Ctrl T. Now right click and flip it horizontally, this one. Fine. Now adjust the position and place it image right side. Now let's move to right side. As I said before, we're going to add 3 images. We're going to use custom made shape. If you want, you can create normal shapes like rectangle or circle. Here I'm going to use custom shape. For that, go to project file, open image 6 inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Yes, we are going to use this image as our image placeholder. I'll place it right above all our layers. First image goes here. I'll create a duplicate copy, Ctrl J. I'll move it a little bit to right side. Now I'll create another duplicate copy, Ctrl J. I'll move it here. Adjust the spacings using your keyboard arrow keys. Now hold Ctrl key and select all the three layers. And now you can adjust the spacings using your keyboard arrow keys. Once you're done, it's time to drop in our model image. I'm sure you know how it works. Go to project file, open image 7 inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside of canvas. Make sure to place the image right above image placeholder. Now right click and clip mask the image. Enable free transfer tool, Ctrl T, and resize it. We're going to repeat very same step for remaining two image placeholder. I'm sure you know how it works. I'll fast forward the process. Fine, now our images are ready. It's time to add minimal effect, which is going to be paper cut effect. Yes, very same step we did on page 2. Now select any image placeholder layer. Right click, blending option. There I'm going to select inside shadow. Here I'm going to keep the mode as normal, opacity as 40, angle as 90, distance as 4, sorry 7, choke as 4 and size as 16. This is before and after, we got minimal effect. Now click OK. Now I'm going to copy paste the effect to remaining two image placeholder. Right click, copy the layer style, paste the layer style. Fine, once you're done, our page 3 is ready. All you gotta do is close the group. Now disable the color palette, save the file. Now let's move to page 4. Go to project file, open album page 4 inside Photoshop. And as I said, this one is a decent ready file. I've given you the color palette. Let's start by creating solid color background. Create a layer, go to color picker, sample and select this pink color. Now fill the color. If you want, you can go with any other color, it's up to you. In this page, we're going to have two images, one on left side and one on right side. Let's start by creating image placeholder. Go to image group. Now create a layer. Now go to color picker, pick black color. Now pick shapes tool. There I'm going to select ellipse tool. Now by holding shift key, create a circle shape like so. Now enable free transform tool and place the shape such a way that 50% of the shape goes outside our canvas. Fine, this is going to be our image placeholder. We are going to drop in our image. Now go to project file, open image 10 inside Photoshop. Now drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Now place the image right above our image placeholder. Right click and clip mask the image. Now resize the image if you want by enabling free transform tool, Ctrl T. Once you're done, next we're going to add stroke effect to make it look little more interesting and colorful. Right click the image placeholder layer, blending option, there select stroke option. I'm going to keep the mode as normal, position as outside. I'll keep the opacity as 100. In the fill option, I'm going with gradient. Now click the gradient bar. We're going to create new gradient color. Select the fourth option. Fine, as I said before, we are going to create a new gradient. On the left side, I'm going with white color. Next, I'll create a new color stop at center here. I'm going with pink color, this one. Now I'm going to change the left side color to kind of bright yellow color, this one. Now click OK. I'm not going to touch other settings here. I'm going with scale 100, angle 90. This one is before and after, looks stunning. We got colorful stroke effect. Now we are done with the left side part. Let's move to right side. I'm going to drop in a circle design here. For that, go to project file, open circle design inside Photoshop. This one is a PNG file. Drag and drop the file inside our canvas. Now enable free transform tool, Ctrl T, and resize it. Fine, next I'm going to change the design color. We're going to create color overlay effect. right click blending option, select color overlay. There I'm going to change the color to bright yellow color, this one. Now click OK. Now it's time to create image placeholder. Let's start by creating a layer inside image group. Now go to color picker, select black color. Now pick ellipse tool. Now hold shift key and create a circle shape like so. Fine, now enable free transform tool, control T and resize it in a way it matches with the background circle design. Fine, once you're done, it's time to drop in our model image. Now go to project file, open image 11 inside Photoshop, drag and drop the image inside our canvas. Make sure to place the image right above our circle shape image placeholder. Now right click and clip mask the image. Now enable free transform tool, control T and resize it. Fine, once you're done, our page 4 is ready. Now close the group, disable the color palette, save the file. Now our album is ready. To print the file, export the file as PDF or PNG and get it printed. So that's it guys, I hope this video is useful to you. Don't forget to hit the like button for more tutorials, subscribe to my channel and please do check out my other videos. Thanks for watching, take care.